So, I was on my way to go get some laundry detergent and some bleach so I can wash the clothes. And being that I'm in the same plaza with TJ Maxx, I decided I was gonna go ahead and run in TJ Maxx, shoot a little quick video just to see if they have anything in there to give you all the idea of what's at my local store once again, if there's anything or if there isn't anything. And I will let you know what my scent of the day is in the process. And it is Windsor Pour Homme from English Laundry. And this actually is the same exact store that I found this fragrance when I first started collecting. I don't even think I was doing reviews at the time when I found this. I may have just started doing reviews, but I was spanking brand new. So with that being said, hope you guys enjoy the video. Peace. And here we are in my local TJ Maxx. Let's get to it. So as you can see, there is some John Varvatos there. A whole lot of, there's Banana Republic Neroli Woods. That's a pretty good fragrance. They had several of those, but you can see those Hugo Boss fragrances are scattered out throughout there. Abercrombie & Fitch First Instinct Blue. I think that was a 100 ml bottle. I was trying to see the price on it, but it was kind of hard, the spot that they had it in. Hugo Boss Iced, which is a very good fragrance. I actually like that one a lot. Some more Banana Republic. Some more Banana Republic down here. I think that was Pure White. D Squared Wood. Lacoste Essential. That is a very good smelling fragrance. Not the greatest in performance, but if you're looking for an office friendly scent, that is the one. One of my favorites from Burberry. That is Burberry for Men. Classic fragrance. Davidoff Cool Water. I also own this one. Can't go wrong with Cool Water. There's Montblanc Individual. They had two of those. Not sure if those are discontinued or not, but I've been hearing rumblings that they are. And here are more fragrances. Michael Kors. I have this one. It's okay. Okay, they have Dolce & Gabbana Light Blue for Women, Pour Femme, which is a pretty good fragrance. I know a lot of guys don't want to wear feminine type products, but it doesn't smell that feminine. Here's some Penguin stuff. I'm not a huge fan of Penguin. When I first started doing fragrances, I was just going to the store and just picking up anything, and those were some of the fragrances I used to pick up. They're okay, office friendly type scents. They don't, on my skin, last a long time. They're just okay. Euphoria for Men, I had that one. It's not bad. It's pretty good. D Squared Wood. It's okay. I don't know. I found it. Not many people were talking about it at the time. And after, you know, smelling it on myself and giving it some wearings, it's not the best. Another Penguin. I've never smelled that one though. Hugo Boss, just different. That's actually a pretty decent fragrance too. Cremo Body Wash. Fresh Citrus, that's one that I haven't seen before. Mont Blanc. This was interesting to me. And it said for men on the sticker, but I wasn't sure if it was for men or for women. So I passed on it, but it was kind of interesting. I almost bought it. Almost. But that was a Mont Blanc Starwalker.
this Burberry Touch here, classic, classy scent. There it is, Mont Blanc's Starwalker. I think that may be discontinued also. And then down here at the bottom, you see more body wash. I've tried some of these, not all of them. And I'm not sure exactly what to think. There's the John Varvatos Nick Jonas fragrance. I think I have that one. I haven't worn it yet. And now I'm going around on the side where they have more beard products. Cremo, hot beard oil. Never tried this product. I wonder how it works. As you can see, they have grooming products like nail clippers, brushes, combs, beard combs, and stuff like that. And this is their little clearance table. And they didn't have much that I was interested in. I did see a few things that look fragrance related, but that ended up being an aftershave. There's one fragrance there, but it wasn't worth even mentioning. And I went back to another shelf that was next to me. I was actually headed towards the women's section and I saw all the beard oils and stuff, so I turned and went back. But some of these products, these Arlo's products, I have tried before and they are pretty good. I haven't tried this though. Lots and lots of beard products. They have deodorants. There's the Arlo's beard wash and beard oil combo. And all of these beard oils are inexpensive. So if you don't have a specific beard oil or beard oil or beard wash or anything like that, definitely check out what TJ Maxx has to offer. Marshall's also has beard products. Here's some Duke Cannon soap. I'm not sure how good these soaps are. I've heard a few people talk about them. I've seen commercials on them. Not so many as of lately, but they had quite a few of these soaps. Men's shaving soap, coconut oil, and other stuff in it. And I also know that people like using all natural. There's Cremo has one, an exfoliating bar. A lot of people are into natural soaps and stuff like that, and I get it. But if you're not, if you're like me who don't really care at the moment what kind of soap you use, as long as it smells good, hey, go for it. There's another Duke Cannon, big ass beer soap, beer soap. And that is pretty much it. Arlo's lip balms if you need chapstick. Never tried this one before, but I have seen it. Bad to the beard.
So not much going on in TJ Maxx, as y'all can see. I'm gonna walk down to Bell's and check back with you.
All right, so here we are at our local Bell's. And as you can see, there's not much here. I'm not a huge K Kenneth Cole guy, but there are some people who do like Kenneth Cole. There's some Eternity, some Halston, some Euphoria, lots of Curve. It's more Euphoria here. Beverly Hills Polo Club stuff, in which I'm not a fan of. Those, I believe, were the body sprays. More Curve here. They have the OG Classic Curve, which I do love. They have Coach for Men, which in my personal opinion was about the only purchase I would have made if I had to buy something out of here this particular day. Cool Water, in which I already have. This beard oil by Ed Hardy is great. It smells fantastic. It does smell like an Ed Hardy fragrance. It's not anything that's going to kill you or choke you out. Very good stuff. For you shavers out there, if you're looking for a shave brush, an inexpensive one, definitely check out your local Bell's or Burke's. I think it's also called Burke's Outlet, as my boy Trey Scent says in his area. And everything else you're going to see from this end cap back is going to be mostly about electronics. So not much fragrance related here. There is an Eccentric from Dunhill. It actually came out of a gift set. And somebody must have taken the fragrance and left that, so they just put it on the shelf. Now here are the big Bluetooth speakers, and the one I'm gonna be pondering on here for the longest is the one I really wanted to get. I have a bunch of smaller Bluetooth speakers. I just want to get rid of all of those and get something bigger like this one, so I may go back and get it. It was only like $30 some odd, which wasn't bad. Here's the price, $39.99, so about $40. It's not bad. And the rest of the stuff is just Bluetooth things, like the earpieces for your phone, holsters and stuff. So that's it. So I am home, and obviously, duh. So I just left TJ Maxx. I just also left Bell's, as y'all saw in the footage. For me, there wasn't much in those stores. Some of that stuff I already have or have had. But for the most part, for somebody who's looking for something like those Banana Republics, maybe that Coach, there was some other fragrances, like maybe the Hugo Iced. I really like that fragrance. There were a few other ones there. Bell's, they used to have more, but what they had, it just was what it was. I think the best thing I found in Bell's was probably that Coach for Men. Other than that, really not much to choose from if you're asking me personally. But what I did walk away from TJ Maxx with, that I do not have or did not have, I picked up a body wash, and it was that Fresh Citrus from Cremo. Can't wait to give this some wearing or use, I should say. Smells good, a citrus fragrance. It's kind of invigorating. It's crisp, clean, fresh. Smells fantastic to me. I only paid $5.99 for it, which is not bad at all. And I also, as y'all saw, all the beard stuff that they have. Now, I know a lot of people like to go all natural. Nothing wrong with that. I haven't hit that level yet. So I try just about anything. But this is another product from Cremo. And this is their hot beard oil. And I think I shot in the video where I picked this up. It's deep conditioning. It's a treatment. Used once weekly for a astonishingly soft and healthy looking beard. Nourishing formula revitalizes coarse, dry facial hair. That is what I picked up.
And also, when I got home today, I got two more packages. I'm not going to reveal what they were. You're going to have to wait for the haul video coming up. But I think I have three more packages coming. And then I'll be all set to do my haul video. And I haven't quite decided. Somebody recommended I chop my haul video up, being that I have so much stuff coming. I thought about it. I may do that. I may chop it up into maybe two parts. But who's to say? But with that being said, hopefully you enjoyed this video. And I will continue to do more videos like this. It'll be very sporadic, though, because I don't go out much. I have to keep my kids, you know, in mind when I'm going out and stuff like that. So with that being said, I don't have a fragrance, but here is to smelling great and the beard looking good. Peace, y'all.